Okay, so today we're reading Mark 11, verses 1 to 11. And this is where Jesus travels on the road through Bethany and Bethphage, which is about 2 miles from Jerusalem. And the elevation at this point is about 2,600 feet. And so from it, you have breathtaking views of the holy city. And the Lord was about to do something he'd never done before, something he'd repeatedly cautioned the others not to do for him. He was going to permit his followers to give a public demonstration of honour to him. And so Jesus rides into Jerusalem on a donkey or a colt, an animal full of prophetic symbolism fit for a king. And the people lay down their outer garments on the road before him. They wave branches, shouting, "Hosanna," which means "Save us now," repeating the words of the psalmist in Psalm 118. And we call this event the triumphal entry. But no Roman would have used that term of Jesus's entry into Jerusalem. An official Roman triumph was indeed something to behold. When a Roman general came back to Rome, he was coming with his conquest over an enemy, and he was welcomed home with an elaborate official parade of people, especially those he'd conquered. And in this parade, he would have those who he'd conquered as trophies of war and the illustrious prisoners that he carried with him, that he captured, riding in a long train before him. You know, one commentator says this. He says, the entry of Jesus is not triumphal. Jesus doesn't enter Jerusalem on a white charger. He doesn't brandish a series of war trophies in front of people. He doesn't have a train of captives and doesn't have a trail behind him either. In fact, within the week, Roman guards would lead Jesus out of the city of Jerusalem as a defeated captive himself, dying the death of a slave. And the crowd here shout, "Hosanna, save us," thinking that Jesus has come to save them from their political enemies, from the reality that they experience at that time. But in fact, Jesus is doing something much deeper. There's something much deeper going on. Because Jesus' entry into Jerusalem may not have been a victorious triumph in the Roman sense, but it was a triumph nonetheless. He was God's anointed king and saviour. A Roman general had to kill at least 5,000 enemy soldiers to merit having a triumph on their return back to Rome. Within a few weeks, we'd read in the Gospel, and particularly in Acts of the Apostles, of 5,000 Jews who with transformed lives becoming followers of Jesus. Christ's triumph would be the victory of love over hate, of truth over error, of life over death. And I wonder for us whether we experience the joy of those crowds welcoming Jesus into Jerusalem. How will you welcome Jesus as Saviour this Easter?